Good morning. This is an audio update, a morning brief here, August 30th, 8:39 a.m. Eastern Time for the grain markets, and I'm Rich Posse for Critical Point. Okay, so we've got the December corn futures that the current high over the last few hours, coming off the low in Friday, was nothing more than an intraday high, but it's higher than the next more important high, the level four. This suggests the larger level three trend is probably still up and that the market ought to bounce today to finish off a level four upswing from, say, Friday's low. So best forecast is there's a chance for this to bounce a bit today. But looking out tomorrow, the market should be down. So it could bounce a little bit today and start down tomorrow. Today. It might stay up all day and then just sell it overnight and tomorrow. But it ought to be lower by tomorrow for the level four swings. And here's the key. Any level four top moving forward for the rest of this week should be a level three top. So therefore, any pop today could very well trigger the more important level three top. We had a level three bottom, a week ago, and it's time for a top this week. We had been forecasting last week to anticipate a 1.5 to 2 week down move. We believe that's still going to occur because we believe if it tops for level three this week, the earliest to bottom will be next week for level three. We think there's more time to decline and also more downside price potential than upside. Okay, so we think these three levels I gave you are going to hold cap corn, that there really isn't any fundamental reason to rally corn. And there's a lot of people who believe you can sell all the corn you want at 550. It's a safe number to sell. Well, this also means the buyer has to pay that high, so we have an equilibrium, but the buyer doesn't need to pay any higher. Okay, I think buyers don't need a lot of corn right now. They're trying to hold out for the new crop, but they need to take care of day-to-day business, and they'll have to buy something. I think the seller's trying to hold out as best as possible and keep prices high, but they're the ones who are going to lose in the end because we're going to have the bins refilled. There's going to be more corn. I think the La Nina going on isn't large enough, strong enough. It's too soon. I don't think it's going to cause a problem, at least today, for South America, and we're seeing some evidence of rains that might be light, but it almost looked like some maps were showing good coverage in terms of space area, okay? And not only that, La Nina could be only an Argentina story, which doesn't have to be that bullish to the U.S. markets, but it probably will be. We're seeing analysts in South America and specifically in Brazil forecasting huge corn and soybean crops next year. So I just feel like things have got to be extremely limited here for a little while at least until we can get a harvest low in place for the U.S. market. And you know my long-term stance, I just got to be bearish into June of next year and maybe even into November of next year. And I'm bearish to 480 to as low as 430 going all the way out to the end of next year. So we're going to get sub $5 someday. And in not too distant future, I think we'll see a 522. Now, that target is still on our charts. I think it gets struck. I think we've seen a couple of strikes at the 532, and I think that's enough. I think the next time it goes to 532, it's going to keep going lower. Okay, so that's our December corn stance again. You may see a little pop today, but I think ultimately looking out into next week, corn's going lower. Now, another thing they may do is try to hold corn and soybeans up as long as they can, maybe even wheat, into the September report, and they may try to hold them up this week and then give in and sell some ahead of the report, so they'll sell next week, and then maybe they'll even start to buy it just a couple of days before the report if they get enough sold sooner, okay? And it may be just a process where everybody's trying to wait on the September report. They waited on Pro Farmer. They decided it was bearish, but you can see they really didn't get all that bearish about it. So now maybe they decided they actually want a number from USDA. So I'm not saying this market falls apart in the next few days, but I won't be surprised if it does. But it's possibly hang on to that September report. Now, what are we going to get in the September report? I think it's going to be neutral to bearish. And I don't think it's going to be outrageous bearish. I wouldn't be surprised they bump yield a little bit. And there was another crop tour that just took place here in the past week here. That actually, I think, supported pro-farmer numbers. I mean, some of those areas they went to blew the yield way past USDA numbers, above it, that is, okay? But they also admitted they didn't pick up the stressed areas of that particular state. I think it was in Minnesota. And generally, though, they were at least a few bushel higher than USDA numbers. Now, that doesn't mean they'll be right. I don't think USDA is really going to give us a record number, okay? But I think they can give us a little better than what they've shown us. All right, so anyways, yes, I favor a pop, but I still think the bigger picture is actually bearish into harvest time, frankly, and at least into next week. So hopefully you can use that accordingly. Now, violation of the Friday low would suggest it ought to test 540, and I think a break of 540 is probably going to mean they're going to try to test 530. And then you know my stance that if they take it near 532, I think they're finally going to give up and put it on down to 522. And then you know my stance that the upside is probably limited to 566, and I don't think it can even get that high. But I got to leave it on the table. Okay, now, in the soybeans, problem is the model's warning it can top today for that level 3 and just start going lower into next week. But the model's saying this is earliest allowed, and it's not necessarily ideal. I think maybe soybeans doesn't top for that high until Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, frankly, okay? If corn suddenly took a hit, probably beans would go lower, although on a day-to-day basis, it seems quite often here lately, they can do something different. So I don't know what to tell you. If it violates the Friday low, I'd be concerned that even if it hasn't put the level 3 top in, that it will rebound to put that top in and then come down. But at the same time, a violation of Friday's low is bearish. So do you really want to gamble on it snapping back? Will it go higher than the overnight high? So if the November beans trade over under 1307.5, I'm bearish, but I can't rule out that they might, in the next couple of days, put it slightly above 1336.25, the overnight high. That's what you're up against. And the 5-day stochastic is nearly overbought and trying to roll over for a sell signal today. The open interest isn't telling us anything. We've got the same old game just trading beans. Now, in my opinion, the swings are calming down here. And like corn, maybe they're going to try to hold out to the September report. But my guess is somebody needs to do something here to even up their positions ahead of that report. We can get some bigger swings than what we've seen just in the last few days here. So I want to be bearish into next week. I want to be bearish into harvest with soybeans just like corn. But I can't rule out some bounces for that September report. I can't rule out a bounce in the next few days for those two markets before we can get going on that decline. But I must say, at least in the beans, I really don't want to see it go under 1307.5. Now, if we move over to the Chicago wheat, basically it's in a level 3 uptrend and it could stay up all this week. And it really has relative strength to corn and soybeans fundamentally. Not so much technically, it's kind of just setting there. It's not really doing much of anything. But I can see how the global traders and some of the, at least the speculators in the U.S., could bounce wheat all the way back to 760 in the December. I think if I got to trade the upside, I'll probe the wheat. But until they violate last Friday's high at 745, there is a chance it's topping today for a level 3. So I would get nervous as it starts dipping below the 5-day average around 733. It starts getting on down around 730. I think you got to gamble and you got a level 3 top end, and this thing's going down into next week. Even though the model's warning, there's still time to bounce this. You know, we could get trapped that it goes to 730 and then takes off for 750 before it goes on to the level 3 downswing. Ultimately, though, wanting to trade the wheat on the bullish side, I think you got to be quick and nimble. I don't trust it. As I look out to next week, I think all three markets will be lower. And if wheat violates 720, I think it deserves to go to 710 to 7 bucks. I think that's what wheat's really worth. But I'm coming up against some things going on in Europe that can support the entire global trade. And we still got the North Dakota, South Dakota, U.S. issue. And that's probably enough that I could be wrong for a while. And you know, my long-term stance, I wouldn't be surprised wheat is still in a bull market into the end of the year here. I'm not saying it's going tremendously higher. It may not go much higher at all, but it could hold up and do much better than corn and soybeans into the end of the year. All right, that's our stance here at the moment. You know where I'm at. All three markets ought to be lower by next week. It's just a matter of where's the signals. And I'm not calling a level 3 top here in wheat, but I think we're getting awfully close. So watch those support levels, all three markets. You must have a backup plan if you're trying to hold out for a bounce for a few days here yet, and even the model's doing the same thing, and I don't talk enough about this. Sometimes it gets so intense about got to find that top, got to find that bottom that I forget. We've got to have trailing stops, some kind of passive backup system in case the model misses the top and bottom, because it does happen once in a while. Okay, sorry for taking so long here, but that's our update. Hopefully we get off to a good start for the week. I thought the model actually did quite well last week. The model did well over in the stock market, except I messed things up. I tried to front run the model, turned a little too bearish on the stock market there. But other than that, as I look over all the markets, I think the models are running very well. And so here's a thumbs up to keep going with our forecast. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. Have a great day.